Hi yogis, welcome to day 12. Today's practice is going to be short and super sweet. So grab some props with you, a block, and definitely some sort of pillow. Anything you've got will work. Grab that and join me in a seat. We're going to start in a crisscross position, and if it's comfortable, I'm going to invite you to pick your right foot up and place it on top of your left thigh. So a couple of options here. We're really gonna work in this outer glute on our right side. If this is way too much pressure or uncomfortable for your knee, try placing a block there so that you feel supported, but you also feel this really nice opening. If this is completely uncomfortable, you can just take a traditional seated position or a butterfly pose or something that feels okay for your knee. If you've joined me here, start to enjoy this really nice stretch through your outer glute. We did some bridge work yesterday, so your booty might be feeling a little bit of soreness or tightness. That's a good thing. Take a moment to loop your shoulders up, back, and down. You can take your left thumb to the inside arch of your right foot, give it a little bit of a massage. Flex your toes using your hands one direction and the other. Something else that that I find to feel good is to place my fingertips to weave them in between my toes. I know this feels weird. It's like, I don't know if this is a yoga thing or not, but your feet do a lot of work for you, not just in your yoga practice, but throughout the whole day. So making these imaginary spacers in between your feet can really help relieve tension through your feet. And foot pain, if you've ever experienced it, is awful, and it really does radiate throughout your whole body because our feet are our foundation. So enjoy this just for a moment. A little bit of a foot massage if that feels nice. And then stay here, or if you'd like to explore, you can walk your fingertips out forward. Breathing into the stretch of your right outer hip as you explore this movement. If you've got another block close by, you can also place it right underneath your brow bone and work to surrender into this fold. Try not to lift your elbows up. Just allow gravity to let them hang nice and heavy. You can shake your head a little bit side to side, massaging your brow bone. Or just enjoy the stillness. Enjoying the sound of your breath as you slow it down. A traditional yin or restorative yoga practice would have us holding each of these postures for about 5 breaths. So we're not quite holding these moves, these postures, these stretches for quite that long today, but just know that they're now in your toolkit. So if you feel like you need a little bit of yin in your day or in your week, try these poses on your own. Yin poses are so great to do at home as part of our home practice because we can just sit with the postures without having to think about the next move. A lot of the times, like in a power or in a flow class, we're moving from one pose to the next. And so the thought of doing that on our own time with our own thoughts can be a little bit intimidating. But if you just pick 3 to 5 yin restorative poses to do on your own, you could get a full practice in. Allowing your own body, your own breath, and your own mind to be your guide. In yoga, there's a saying that we all are our own best teachers. So yoga instructors serve a purpose of sharing particular movements or stretches or flows with you. But in every single yoga class, whether it be restorative or a power flow or something in between, you are your own best teacher. I nor any other yoga instructor knows what feels best for you. Only you know. So it's super important that you learn to trust your own mind and breath. Slowly walk your way up. And we're just going to switch it out. So as you drop your right foot down, you might need to wiggle your blocks around a little bit here. And then if it felt good on the other side, try it on here. You can pull your left ankle up towards your right hip crease. You can have your leg extended or as pulled in as possible. So make it feel good. And then again, if that block is helpful to you, you can place it under your knee and just feel how that allows you to really ground down through your whole lower body. So you have total support here while you open up. We're gonna do the same thing on the other side. You can either use your hands to give yourself a little bit of a foot massage. If that feels nice, work out all those little kinks in the soles of your feet, all those pressure points that connect throughout our whole bodies. And then if you'd like, you can spread your fingertips wide, just like we're gripping the mat in our downward facing dog. But today you're gonna weave your fingertips in between your toes. You can make little circles here with your wrists, stretching out your toes. And then stay here or find your way into a fold. Tapping into your own intuition and listening to what your body's trying to tell you right now. Our bodies send us signals and messages all day and night, and sometimes it's really difficult to hear those messages. Sometimes our ego gets in the way. Sometimes it's just our to-do lists or our unawareness of our own intuition speaking to us. Our hips in particular, especially for women, hold a lot of emotion, a lot of tension, a lot of stress. And so sometimes when we're in these postures that allow our hip creases to release a little bit, things come up. Emotions get ruffled up, and sometimes there's even a sensation in these postures of like sadness, or sometimes you just tear up and you don't know why. And if this isn't resonating with you and you're like, what is she talking about? Don't worry about it. But I do know that a lot of the times when we are in these more restorative postures and we have time to kind of just sit with ourselves as we stir up these emotions throughout our body, things can come to the surface. And that's a good thing. Rather than allowing them to fester through our body, we're actively releasing them. Releasing anything that might weigh us down, any old thought patterns, anything that's not serving us. Yesterday, we did a lot of work with twisting and with resetting. So hopefully you guzzled your water yesterday. And now you're here to flush it out, to restore.
Awesome job.
slowly walk it all the way up. Next, we're gonna come into a seated cow face pose. So I'm gonna show you once from the front and then I'll turn around and show you the second half from the back. A couple of options with your legs though that I wanna highlight here. So basically you're gonna cross your right foot over top of your left thigh. This might be it for you. This might be like, whoa, that's a really big stretch, I'm good here. Another variation would be to stack your knees over top of one another. And you can press your hands down, lift your hips up and press them forward so that your thighs are squeezing and stacking towards one another. Knees are right on top of each other. Most likely you'll be somewhere in between. So find that in between for you. Find something that feels good that allows your hips to gently open up, but that you can settle into because we will be here for several breaths. So find that positioning with your feet. And then I'm gonna just turn around and show you from the back here. With our arms, we're gonna do something similar. We're gonna lift our right arm up towards the sky and then pat our left shoulder blade. Find a little bit of a stretch through your right tricep. Then you're gonna swim your left hand down to your lower back. Just pause here for a moment. Then you might start to walk your left hand up your back. Your fingertips may or may not connect, and that's really not the goal. If they don't connect, a strap, a dish towel, or you can even use your shirt to hang on to here. Or maybe they do interlace and you can find that bind. So just like the lower body positioning, the stacking of the knees, it's going to look different. And so is this bind with our back body, with our fingertips. But whatever variation you're in, see if you can squeeze your elbows in towards center. So your right arm is pressing up against your right ear and your left elbow is coming towards the bottom of your left rib cage. Of course, we can't forget our alignment here, so continue to stack your vertebrae over top of one another. You can even keep your feet active by flexing your toes. And as always, keep the breath moving, keep it fluid. The hustle and bustle of most of our everyday lives is enough to drive us crazy sometimes in a good way. And so it's so important not only to find the time to rest, as in to sleep or to, you know, watch TV or lay low, things like that, but to deliberately and very intentionally restore. So doing things like these yin yoga poses are super, super restorative for our bodies. They're cleansing for our minds. And they literally change the makeup of our nervous system. Most of our busyness of our day-to-day engages our fight or flight nervous system, or portion of our nervous system. And so yoga in general, and particularly our restorative yoga postures, help us to turn towards our parasympathetic nervous system. That's the one that allows us to breathe slowly, to let go of stress. You might feel a little bit of tingling through your right arm. That's okay. Just rest your hand down on your thigh. Pause here for a moment. Let the blood return. Perfect job. When you're ready, we're gonna uncross our legs and just switch it out to the other side. So this time, you're gonna squeeze your right heel in towards your left glute, and then pick your left foot up and cross it over top of your right thigh. This might be it. Maybe you take it a little bit further, or maybe you go all the way into your full cow face variation by stacking your knees over top of one another. I find it really helpful here to not only squeeze my thighs in towards one another, but to press my weight up and forward. And that allows them to squeeze even further so I can get a really, really nice juicy stretch. Feel this movement. Notice what it feels like. You can utilize blocks and props here as well to support you. And then when you're ready, we're gonna take cow face on the other side. So this time, left fingertips are gonna reach up. Go ahead and pat your right shoulder blade. Feel the tricep stretch right away. And then begin to bring your right hand to your low back. Feel that there's no big arch in your lower back. Notice what that feels like to have great alignment, even in this twisty pretzel pose. And then if you'd like to walk your bottom arm all the way up the length of your spine, maybe connecting your fingertips towards one another, maybe not. Play around, explore. Just like on day two, when we talked about the power of our breath, that comes from our nervous system, or more so we have power over our nervous system by using our breath. And so by slowing down, not only our movements, but also our inhales and our exhales, we can remind our body that it's okay to relax. It's okay to slow down, and it's okay to let go. By doing so, our body is able to restore, replenish, and rejuvenate itself. Continue to feel this stretch through both arms. If your top arm is getting a little bit tingly, just breathe through it. Just one more breath. And then exhale, slowly unwind, place your palms on your left leg. Pause here for a moment. Allow the blood to drop down your arms once more. Shoulder blades press up, back, and down. Long spine. When you're ready, uncross your feet. Nice job. And we're gonna extend them all the way out long. You can wiggle them out a little bit here, letting go of some built up energy if you've got it. And then when you're ready, flex your toes. Pause here. Use your inhale to lift your fingertips really high, energizing inhale. And then as you exhale, keep your spine super flat. So try not to round through your shoulders and just continue to reach forward once you can't reach any further without rounding your spine. Pause there. Take a breath in and exhale, maybe reach a little further. One more breath here, inhale. And exhale, plant your palms down. Now you can begin to round through your spine. It might feel really nice here to weave your arms underneath your knees. Use that as a little bit of support, a little bit of cushion. You can also roll up a blanket or a towel or place your bolster underneath your knees. Just find a way that you can surrender down into this posture. If your head is relatively close to your thighs and your bolster or block is within reach, you can also grab this guy. Continue to find as much support as possible. Feel the breath traveling throughout the length of your spine. Feel that restoration in your cells. Slowly unwind and press it all the way up. Great job. Next, you are going to want your bolster or pillow or whatever you've got. We're going to set up into a low lunge and utilize our bolster here. So place your palms down and you're just going to walk your right foot to the top edge of your mat. You might need to take a couple little steps. You can use your hand to kind of hike your foot up. And then you're really going to squeeze this bolster or towel, pillow, whatever, towards the back thigh and then lock it in with your right ankle. So we're coming into a low lunge, but you'll notice right away that by using the bolster and having that support underneath our left thigh, we actually get a bigger opening through our left hip crease. We're keeping the integrity in our 90 degree bend on the right. And then you can either tent up on your fingertips here, or if you want to work a little less through your finger pads, just place your palms on some blocks. Allow your chest to stay expanded and your breath to stay fluid. Great job. From here, we're going to move into a half pigeon pose utilizing our prop. So heel toe your right foot all the way across to meet your left palm. And then before you drop your right knee towards your right wrist, you're gonna bring your bolster towards diagonal so that this right thigh can surrender all the way down onto your prop. And then you can pull your right ankle in towards your left hip, that's okay. Again, wiggle around, make it feel good, make it feel comfortable. And then once you've got a comfortable positioning here with your legs, then start to walk your hands or your forearms down towards the mat. I really like this block today, so I'm gonna continue to use it so I can surrender the crown of my head, or rather this brow bone, down to the mat. So that gravity is doing its thing, my body is doing its thing, but I'm not really working myself, not hard. I'm setting myself up for restoration, for rest. And by doing so, I'm releasing the need to hold on, to clench, to force. Slowly lift your head up, walk back onto your palms, and then we're gonna work back into a tabletop. So get there however is accessible for you. Realign your prop, your bolster, and then on the other side, we're going to do the exact same thing. So squeeze your bolster towards your right thigh, and then walk your left leg forward. Set it up here so that you feel total support underneath your back leg. And then sink down into this posture and make it feel good. When you're ready, set up for your half pigeon. Left foot comes across to your right wrist. Bring your bolster towards catty corner and then allow your left thigh to surrender all the way down. Big, huge opener through your left hip. Wiggle it around until you get comfortable. And then surrender your chest down towards the mat.
This is another one of those poses that kind of stirs up some stuff. So if that's you today, embrace it. If you're just like, I don't know what you're talking about, but this is not comfortable, embrace it. Sometimes these super deep stretches are uncomfortable. But working through adversity is uncomfortable. So getting rid of those things that might be stuck, it's not always comfortable. I will caveat that with, if you feel pain at any point in any part of yoga, get out of a pose. That's not the discomfort I'm talking about. The discomfort I'm talking about is that idea that we're not moving enough, we're not moving fast enough, I'm not sweating enough. Maybe, you know, we're in this pose too long, or this stretch is deep, or I want to do the next pose. What is the next pose? You know, all these things that pop around in our minds, kind of like a popcorn maker throughout our yoga practice. And so step one, oftentimes, is to release the distractions from outside, the world outside of our mat. So just showing up on our mats and letting go of all of the things that await us when we get off of our mats. But then step two is, when we're on our mats, how can we find actual presence in our breath without worrying about what posture does come next? And if that was you, we're almost to our last posture. So bear with me. Unwind yourself back to a tabletop. And next, we're going to close out today's practice in legs up the wall. So if you've never done this posture before, it's exactly as it sounds. You're literally going to stack your legs up the wall. So if you don't have a wall, you can do this by just lifting your feet up in the air, and that's perfectly fine. If you do have a wall, I'm going to invite you to lift your legs up. You're gonna have to shift your hips towards the wall so that it's pretty close, and then recline all the way onto your backs. Again, this one, there's like not the most, there's no one like super graceful way to get into it. So just get there however you can. You can also place your feet on a chair. If you don't have a wall here, you can bring your legs up to 90 degrees and rest your calves on a chair. That's another option as well. Once you get there though, I really want you to settle in. So if you need to get out any little wiggles, anything at all, feel free. Make sure you've got lots of space around you so that you can surrender down in this pose. If you're feeling a little bit chilly, I also invite you to bring a blanket. Yin poses drop our body temperature as our body starts to quiet down, to slow down. So get cozy here. It's the moral of that story. Just like in all of our other postures, make this super supportive. So you shouldn't have to be really holding. If you don't have a wall and you are just finding legs up the wall pose, it's a little bit of extra work, which is why the wall is super nice, or the chair or whatever you've got. But legs up the wall will do the trick too. Legs up the wall without the wall is what I meant. Okay, keep breathing. Notice here how the blood is recirculating throughout the full length of your body. So because our heart space is lower than our limbs, specifically than our feet, it allows the blood to recirculate through our toes, restoring and regenerating, and then sending it back to the heart.
You can place your hands on your heart here as a reminder that the blood is pumping in and out, that fresh oxygen, that fresh breath. And hopefully after yesterday's twisty reset, this feels a little restorative. So that as you get up and off of your mat into the remainder of the day, you feel restored. Your body feels complete. It feels perfect just the way it is. Stay here for as long as you can. Fun fact, I read a study one time that legs up the wall pose for 30 minutes was equivalent to several hours of sleep. So if you struggle with sleeping issues, or maybe you have babies at home and you can't get a full night's sleep, or you had a hard day at work and you've been stressed, or, you know, the list goes on. Find a few moments, even if it's not 30 full minutes, find a few moments in this quiet, legs up the wall posture and notice how it leaves your body feeling. See if you can find that feeling of restoration. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Namaste.